Imagine this. You are a developer at an agency, or maybe you're a tech lead, and every project you do has their own marketing, their own design, and it looks amazing, their own messaging, but generally the tech is relatively similar, right? They all need something like Nuxt or Next or Astro on the front end, flexible stuff. And then in the back end, you tend to have, I would say 95% of cases, there's a CMS and maybe a few other bits. But let's focus on that CMS for a second, because as an agency, you have extra needs for that CMS. Wouldn't it be awesome if there was a CMS for just that, built by another agency to sell to agencies? Well, apparently this exists, and this is a Tim Tries video to look into Casey CMS. Before diving into Casey CMS itself, let's talk about a few features that I think every agency-focused CMS should have. First of all is the workspaces, project, you know, teams management. You should be able to make different organizations with different groups and different projects, and to be able to then give certain clients a seat at that project and allow them to do certain things. But then the agency is still in there and is able to help. And I think that's a killer feature. And then with that comes the fact that if you make a little project that you think this is a great base, that you have to be able to clone that project and then constantly clone it, adapt it, beam, new project. I think that is very cool. On top of that, localization and translation is always a thing. Wouldn't it be awesome if that was really easy to manage? And then on top of that, thinking about things like budget, you might not always be able to reach out to like external DAM systems for media management. Well, then a CMS needs to have excellent media management, but also media delivery, right? Being able to crop, width, height, things like that. That's a really important one. And so I realize lots of these features a lot of CMSs have, but do they all have them in the same package? And are they actually decently priced, or does it become outrageous very fast? I think probably Casey has this, but this is a Tim Tries video, so we're gonna have to go in and see it. Because I'm relying on my personal experience of many, many years of using a lot of CMSs and then just diving in without doing too much research. So, here we go. All right, so we're in the Casey dashboard and we are starting up by looking at that whole workspace team project group thing. And so I'm here at Operation Turbo and I've already made some stuff. So Operation Turbo is my organization in here. And then I have another organization called Tim Tries, because it's a Tim Tries video. And then in Operation Turbo, I don't have groups, but I made two projects. And one just came out of like a standard import that Casey gives you. And another one is something I made myself. And there's also in this Tim Tries organization, I have a group called Try It, and then it's a project inside. So there's lots of stuff going on here. And so you can actually quite easily switch between these. Like I can go to Operation Turbo, and then go in my blog posts. And then here I'm in that project. Can also go to another project, which is this one, or I can switch my organization and go to Tim Tries in the group, go to the blog. So, and these can be, they're scoped quite differently. They're actually separate entities, but I'm controlling all of them. And then I can give customers a seat in these different places. And I think this is actually really something that's awesome for agencies, and they do this flawlessly, and it's so cool. So how about we just make a new project in this Try It one here? And so, okay, so we have a new empty project, a new existing project, or yeah, new from existing, and there's a new one from template. So this is that second thing we just talked about. Like if you have this blueprint project that works well for you, that you always kind of use, let's say you make a lot of blogs, or you make a lot of product websites, you might want to have data models called blueprints in Casey that have stuff for products with all their connections or with blogs and authors and media, stuff like that. You can set that up and then clone from that. Well, in this case, let's just go from a new template that they give you, and they actually give you a bunch of starters. Like you can say Nuxt, go for a blog. Astro, go for a blog. And I guess let's have a look at this one. And so they actually give you a bunch of code. It explains stuff. Oh, there's Tailwind, Nuxt. And then you can also just add it to your project. So how about we do that? We don't need an image for now. So I'm just gonna grab this blog call it my project, and then run. And so now it's actually importing everything, creating stuff, and that's really fast. I like this. So this was basically a project that they have as template for that you can use and reuse and whatever. And so they build a bunch of stuff. So how about we click around a bit? So let's click on a blog article here. So I guess every CMS should have certain things and do them really well. And so I'm looking at, okay, there's a title, a slug, which is basically your URL connector. There's an author. Okay, so this is actually something that's linked to something else, it seems. So I can unlink that and then link to an existing document. Okay, so here I can just select another thing, another data model, and connect that in. This is stuff CMSs need to have, and Casey has it. I'm not sure we should talk about that much. If you know something about CMSs, you know this works. I don't think we've set up any sort of translations yet, but I do see that here. So what I'm imagining is that there will be, if you have multilingual, there's just going to be multiple languages here, and these fields are just going to be, there will be multiple fields for the different languages, and they can just turn them on and off here. So that's actually a really simple way to edit this stuff. And let's look at some other things like releases. Yeah, I like this. You know, again, this is a Tim Tries video. I have not seen this yet. I'm just looking at it now to see if it works. And I can imagine if you make a new page and for, let's consider the length of this video. So I'm not going to do all that, but I imagine if you make a page, you can create a release and add something to that release. Oh, and then you can just add which ones you want. So I want to have home and about, link this stuff. And then you can say, okay, in a few days, beam. You can even select your time zone. Oh, this is cool. So what this means is that if one of your clients has like a big release with a campaign, you can already make all your stuff and then add that to this release and it all goes live. And you can actually say, you know what, we can publish and unpublish in this release. I like this. This is good stuff. I've always had struggles with this, right? It's nice to have management like this in your project. And then we have assets. I already mentioned we need very solid ways of actually managing these assets, adding tags to them, whatever, but then also delivering them through a CDN and then have, you know, a width and a height and a quality setting, stuff like that. So this looks like a pretty simple, just a list of stuff where you can list it like this. And then, okay, let's have a look at what we can do with these things. So we have title, source, description, keywords. Okay, so you can do a few things here with extra stuff, and I like this dominant color thing. And I imagine that that comes in on upload. And so you can use that. Let's say this is a portrait image rather than a landscape, but you're showing it as a portrait on the website. You can put that color behind, or if you do like a custom preloader, you can have the color first and then the image comes in. Good stuff. And so there's actually some magic here, so we can preview. Okay, that makes sense. But there's also an edit. All right, let's see what can we do with this. So there's cropping, rotate, flip, zoom. I like it when I do this. So now it probably crops. I would have loved to see, like, you know, I want to focus on the eyes, something like that, but that might come later. And then we have fine tune, so we can do, oh yeah, look at that. That's kind of fun. Not sure how often you would use this, but it could be pretty cool when you do stuff like opacity and then we make it like a little bit like this, because you could have text over it. And in certain instances, you want that. For now, let's not save this because I don't want to screw up my demo environment here. But that's cool. Good basics in place. And then the last thing is Playground. And we didn't even talk about this, but this system has GraphQL as an API. And some people might not like that, but a lot of people will. And so you can see that this Playground is fully integrated in the KC system here, which I like. It's cool. It's just, it fits like in the CMS, and we can just grab all the blog posts with the edges, and then for every note I want the ID, the slug, and the headline. Let's see how that comes up. There we go. This is just really solid, simple, fast, just works. So I actually really like this system. It looks great. It's easy to navigate. And you know what? I really like GraphQL now. You saw my video from last week where I actually went into the best Nuxt 3 version of GraphQL. You know what I'll do? I'm going to cut here. I'm going to make a starter for Casey. I think that's actually a good move. because I'm getting pretty excited by this stuff. And so I'll be back soon and I'll show you the starter that I made so you can actually get started with KC. And if you like Nuxt, of course, that should be a nice way to get you started. Cheers.
Approximately 10 hours later.
All right. Different day, different outfit, same light. Makes me happy as a YouTuber. Anyway, so I've created this starter. And so we're here on GitHub. And so there's the Nuxt 3 KC starter at the Tim Bennix account. So you can find this and you can actually give this a go. And this is very similar to my previous video that was about Nuxt 3 and like the super clean way to set up GraphQL and querying it in Nuxt 3. And so if you don't know the ins and outs of this, go there. But you know, there's like a few additions now, so you can actually look at what you need to do to get it to work with KC. And of course you need a Nuxt GraphQL client, and in your environment variables you need a KC host and a KC API key. And what's different here from my previous video is that we now have a client specifically to KC, and you can set a host and you can set headers, because you need to set the XKC API key header to make things work. And after that, it's all the same. You can query based on GraphQL files and then just go ahead. And I've added a few extra fun bits that I learned about KC while I was making this starter. So I added Tailwind, because somehow nowadays, when I think about CSS, I just use Tailwind. Then I've also created a custom KC Nuxt image provider. So you can just use Nuxt image and then use the, you know, the quality settings and the width and height and stuff like that from KC. And that works pretty well. So I thought I'd just give you that little extra thing. And then KC also has rich text, of course. This is a blog example. So we need to somehow get that rich text JSON and make it into HTML. And they have a package and I've added that in. And then for the rest, it's very similar. And I built this. So this is that blog post project we looked at. And so I just made a list of all the blog posts. And of course, these images are now through the Nuxt image provider. And the query is query all my blog posts. And then when you hit one, it actually goes to a page and you can see this image is actually cropped. This is the original. This comes from the rich text. And this is like a hero image that I added myself in the code. And so we'll show you the code in a sec, but that means like you can actually use Nuxt image to lazy load this stuff and make it super fast, and then use the rich text and make it HTML. And so it's a very simple overview. I'm not intending to build you everything here. It's just a simple thing you can use to get started. And so the queries I've been doing in KC is give me all blog articles. So let's execute that one. And then you have get all articles, but by slug. And you can add a where clause when the slug is a certain variable, a string that you add. So let's go into the code. And so the only difference is with the code from my last video is that now we are setting this up, right? We're adding a KC client with the API key and the host. And so then we have a little configuration just for the specific image provider. We'll get there in a sec. So what's so cool about this setup is that you can actually make a folder called queries and just add your GraphQL files in here. So to be able to get all the blog articles, I do that same query as we just saw in the playground. And to get them by slug, we do the same query as we again just saw in the playground. So let me just show you what happens when you use this setup, because it does this amazing code gen thing that is also typed. All right, so when I now go to my page and I go to the index, what I can do while you do, you know, yarn build or whatever you use, PNPM, all the fun stuff, or when you do dev, actually it creates a GraphQL folder in the .nuxt folder where it has all the typings and all the stuff that the KC schema gives you, it creates for you. And it makes you these lovely functions that you can now use. GraphQL blog articles, GraphQL all blog articles by slug. Remember? Blog articles, all blog articles by slug. So we now have functions to query these. So when I go to my homepage now, or my index, I can actually say, give me the data, and then it is GraphQL blog articles. I make it computed because I don't want to go over all the edges and whatever that stuff inside my loop. You don't have to do this per se. But then what you can do is you just get that data because you fired up this function. And then you just loop. And I made like a little card function that shows you all that these cards, right? Which is this card, card, card. And so that component is very simple. It literally just has the article as the prop, and then it has a next link to the article by slug, because the article has a slug in this blueprint or data model. And then you can just like, if there's a header, teaser headline, render it. And then here is that next image thing. I'm gonna jump to this in a sec, but first I wanna show you how to show a page by slug using that query, and then we'll talk about next image. So we also now have an article and then a slug.view. And then when it's in these brackets, it means it's a dynamic URL. And so what you can do here is actually grab the slug from the URL and then just say GraphQL all block articles by slug. And then the slug actually is that slug that you just got from the URL. And in that function, when you look at that, it actually now will fill out this slug as this. And now it will do the query with that variable and you get back exactly what you need, which is click on this. This is now my slug and this is what it's returning. Which makes this so clean, because I just had to do this really simple thing of give me the data. And then I still went over it a little bit to clean it up, because you get all the edges and things. This is just GraphQL stuff. So I made a computed variable to clean it up. And then you just have article headline, article author name, all that stuff. You can build whatever you want. So I promised you to go to that image. And after that, let's have a look at that rich text also. So here for the image. So next image, for the people that don't know, is really amazing, because it basically is an image tag that is enriched by next goodness. And we won't go into it too much. There's a few videos on my channel about next image. And it just helps you to make images responsive, so responsive, makes them optimized, whatever. And so I just said for small screens and up, make it 100% wide. Very simple. And so you can actually do width and height, and based on that, it might do a crop if you want. And so it needs to know a provider, because Next Image works really good for local images, but it could also work for Cloudinary, Binder, Netlify, like they have a lot of providers. And I just made my own, so it knows how to put width, height, all the other properties, and put that on the URL to be able to work. So we can look at providers called Casey. This is a very simple one right now. So I have a width and a height and a quality property. You join them by the ampersand. And this is the formatter, key value. And so now it just makes Casey URLs for us for each image that you need. And you can kind of figure out how to concatenate all these things yourself if you want to, if you have a more complex provider. And now you have a Casey image provider that just works with Next Image without any complications. And now let's have a look at that rich text thing. So there's a rich text renderer component that comes from Casey. And then in there, you can actually say, okay, which node do I get? Well, from the text, I need the JSON object. And then there could be connections to other components in here that would then be rendered by this component. And there's also this block map, and this is where it gets pretty interesting. So let's have a look at these overrides here. You see that document link? That's this one. And so here what it can do, if it finds, let's say, an image connection, right? If the component type name that it connects to is an asset and there's an ID that exists, well, just make it next image now. And so you can override. So you can also look for if this is a paragraph or if it's a header, let me just do my own HTML based on the data that I get. So you can kind of tweak it. And so this is what I want to show you, because it's such a clean way to use Casey. And I haven't even touched their SDK. How about that? Anyways, I'm excited for agencies to use this stuff. It's simple. It does all the things a CMS needs to do, but it has these little extra tweaks that agencies need. So this is a Tim Trice, and I'm thoroughly impressed. I did not expect it, because it was yet another CMS, but they found their niche. They went into it and they dealt with it. All right, there you go. Yet another 10 tries. Speak soon. Cheers.